खुबोर कबातीसी टीवी लवन राशिफी दक ऑरेंज निसान लूम्सो पोनिया फैब्रिकेट चिलोंग रिंकत बट का फिटोरियम का दुकान की तियार किलान में कबा भातम हकदोर कबाबित हन्नोंग थुमाई ओल्ड बीट हाउस चिलोंग
Haba jubab ye ka mat ye keren balawan ra da u MLA ka nongpo constituency u ba Meral Bonds im halor ki kampen roy ki ba dey ha kaput ki ba ka sorkar Assam ka wan man tey jubor ha ki jaka bahab apa upo usam jong ke jela Meghalaya kat ba ki kampen roy ba wan ra da ka sorkar Meghalaya pat ki sya pensenge ha ka sorkar Assam u menteri rang ba ke jela u Konrad Kongkel Sangma ula ong बखम्बोन की बला पनसंगे देख मेघालिया ये की काम पनरोय का असाम बट उलिया थोरु बखिदन हडो खन रेतली की काम पनरोय का असाम बला पनसंगे देख सरकार मेघालिया कट बखिदन पतंग साउतली की काम पनरोय का मेघालिया हखपोट बला पनसंगे देख सरकार असाम उकनराद उला ओंगरु बकादन ग जिंग ये करन कबा नका पोर्स कपोर हपडेंग का मेघालिया बट असाम बन पनबे या किनी की काम
मिस्टर स्पीकर सर Thank you for allowing me to raise this short duration discussion under Rule 50 of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business of Meghalaya Legislative Assembly under the caption Buram Tangka Assam Yak Status Quo Hapedeng Ka Assam Ban Meghalaya. Sir.
Yeah, you may initiate.
Thank you, sir, for allowing me to raise this very important issues and topic that has been lying there for so long between two counterparts, that is Meghalaya and Assam, sir. Sir, we know that this issue has been ongoing for the past 49 years. Our state will celebrate Golden Jubilee 50th year next year, that is in 2022. Sir, our state share a long boundary with Assam, which is around 884.9 kilometer. At the same time, share a boundary, international boundary with Bangladesh, which is around 444 kilometer. So with Assam, there are so many districts that is coincide with our state, like Dima Hasaw, around 124 kilometer, with Kachar district, around 19.5 kilometer, with West Karbi Anglong, around 162 kilometer, Morigaon district, around 14.5 kilometer, Kamrup Metro, around 79.7 kilometer, Kamrup Rural, around 200.9 kilometer, Golpara district, around 169.8 kilometer, Dhubri district around 15.18 kilometer, and South Salmara Mankachar around 98.32 kilometer. Along this long stretch of 884 kilometers, sir, there are so many places which is a disputed area which has been identified also as area of difference. There are 12 area of difference that has been identified. Since 1972, since the inception of our state till date, there has been 22 times talk at the chief minister level and 9 times at the chief secretary level. Dialogue have started, and our leaders in the past, they have tried, they have delivered their stand and exchange ideas and dialogue, and it has been continued till date. Dialogue at the chief minister level has happened in the 70s 3 times, in the 80s 7 times, in the 90s 5 times, in the 2000 6 times, and from 2011 to 2020 only once. We have seen in the preceding year that it was in 1992, during the tenure of Dr. Didi Lapang as the chief minister at that time, that 4 times at the chief minister level talk has happened. And subsequently, talks between the deputy commissioner level, superintendent of police level of the district like West Khasi Hill, Rivoi district, West Giant Hills, with their counterpart of West Karbi Anglong or Kamrup Rural and Metro. It's happening in the past. So, I'm not saying that this issue can be solved overnight. It is a long pending issue. We need a proper dialogue and seriousness from the part of the government. And we hope through continuous dialogue and deliberation that we can solve this very, very important issue of our state. In due course of time, talk has arrived at, and we have seen that two counterparts between Meghalaya and Assam, they have arrived at status quo, and developmental activities on both sides, it should not be disturbed, and it should go on. So, even though status quo is there, from time to time, we have been experiencing that many developmental activities has been disturbed, has been stopped by our counterpart Assam for many developmental work from the government of Meghalaya. This has happened in the past, and it has happened recently also. For example, like the building of SSA school in Madanumwang has been stopped. The building of ICDS building in the same village has been stopped. The building of rearing house of sericulture also has been disturbed. Whereas we have seen that many developmental activities that have been carried by the government of Assam, it is on. For example, PMGSY at Balakhawan, police outpost at Umru, road at Sabuda, sports complex at Umlaper, and the latest one is that transit camp in Khanapara Raj Marwet, Himamlim, Rivoi district. We have seen with special reference for the encroachment in this, as we have discussed during question hour also, one of the main issue and the reason is that the landowner, those people at the border, they have been lured by our counterpart to register their land to get benefit from Assam. So this is the issue that the government, the district council has to work together to see that we should not lose more land. For example, the building of transit camp in Khanapara, which is very much at our nose, each and every one of us, we used to pass through that area. We have seen the building has been started since 2019 from the Transport Department of the Government of Assam. I don't know, but we have seen through media report that the concerned Raj Marwet, the CM of Raj Marwet, maybe with the landowner, they have informed the authority, maybe through the Deputy Commissioner, maybe through the Kasil Autonomous District Council, but nothing has happened. And we have seen that this issue has come to the limelight, and the government has to step in and to see possibility that this thing should not happen. The Kasil Autonomous District Council, on the 23rd of December 2020, they have wrote a letter to the government of Assam, to the chief secretary and to different departments, so that the government of Assam, they will stop the work. But till now, the construction is going on. We have seen that the state government has to step in to look into, in tandem with the district council being the custodian of the land under sixth schedule. We would like to see that the government will be serious on this issue and to book to all those who are involved, or maybe they are not involved but they have no guts to counter with the government of Assam. So this is the time that the state government has to step in, have to look into, to see how can we expect the CM of Raj Marwet or the KHADC. They cannot solve this issue if the government wouldn't step in and help and walk shoulder to shoulder. Because we understand that if the government of Assam will receive a letter from district council from KHADC, they wouldn't bother even to reply also. I have seen that. The CM of that particular area also, if he raised his voice, nobody will listen to him. So it is the part of the government to look into, to step in at the very highest level, at the chief minister level. Talk has to be there, and this issue has to be solved. And we don't want to see, we would urge the government that we should not lose more land. Sir, as a responsible party, I remember in January, Ribhoi District Congress Committee also, we had a delegation, and we said that very particular place. And it really happened. We can see from our own eyes, and we have reported to the authority also, and we would like to see that this issue will be taken up seriously. Sir, encroachment by our counterpart is increasing day by day. As per report, it is not happening only in Khanapara. Apart from different parts bordering East Jayanta Hills or Ribhoi district, villages like Umtranga, Pilangkata, Umsen, Yongkuli, every day this encroachment is there. Government has to act very quickly, because we know that the government of Assam is very prompt, sir, in giving developmental work, activities, be it the school, roads, community hall, footpath, electricity, in those parts of our border. So we would like to see that our state also will come up with proper mechanism how to regulate all this issue to solve at the earliest. I would like to see, as has been mentioned by Honorable Chief Minister, that the Chief Minister level talk, it should have happened in April 2020, but due to the pandemic. But we hope that in these years, that the government will take serious note, especially after the election in Assam, that serious talk will be there. Recently, we have seen talk between the Deputy Commissioner of Ribhoi District, West Jayanta Hills, and their counterpart from West Karbi Anglong in Jowai. Because there is election from Assam, they have requested so many issues, including for not supplying of liquor illegally during election that side. But we have seen in the past from our counterpart from the other side, they even harass the farmer in the village known Umsopho. They erect the gate there to collect revenue from the farmers also. Farmers from those areas, they have been harassed. They have gone through very thick and thin to supply their broomstick and other agricultural produce that they have. So we would like to see that the government will be prompt and to see that this issue has to be solved as soon as possible. At the same time, the Interstate Border Area Development Program, we have seen in the past there has been the earmark for the fund from the Finance Department, but in this recent year we have come across that is less allocation for this department also. We would like to see in days to come, especially during this budget session, that the government will take serious note that a special provision of fund has to be there for Interstate Border Area Development Program, so that those villages in our border, they will feel safe, Mr. Chairman, sir, so that they will feel safe, that they have good infrastructure, like good roads, good school building, footpath, and other developmental activities, community hall, so that they will feel they are still within this very state of Meghalaya. At the time, every dialogue, it will be happen in due course of time. I would like to urge the government to take on board all the stakeholders, which include the district council, the traditional chief, the Sim Raj, the Sim Hima, the Rangba Shnong, who will know the proper boundary so that this talk will go on in times to come. This issue need to be taken at the level of those people, to be taken into consideration for those people who really know the ground reality, how we can protect our land. Sir, we would like to see that talk at CM level has to start, as we have said before. We'll take all the stakeholders on board, and at the same time, We would like to see all those comprehensive report that has been submitted by the successive government will look into and we follow up accordingly. At the same time, sir, before I resume my seat, we would like to see that no more encroachment should be there, or farmers should not be harassed, no more stopping of the construction of developmental activities from the state of Meghalaya, which is carried on in the border area, that should not be stopped, and it should be carried on in days to come. And we should see more and more developmental activities will come up in days to come, so that the people of our border area, they will feel safe, and they will feel that still the government of the day is still looking for the problem and the needs. With these few words, I will resume my seat. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, sir.
Any other member would like to participate? Yes, Bak Yofa.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, sir, for allowing me to take part in the short duration discussion moved by the Honourable MBA from Nongpo, Mr. Mirabon's aim under Rule 15 of the Rule and Procedure of Conduct of Business, under the caption Buram Tang from Meghalaya Yaga Status Quo Happening Assam and Meghalaya. Only Meghalaya respect the status quo between Assam and Meghalaya. In this connection, sir, I have two specific points to draw the attention of the MDA government. One, the Athiyabari Umchak Road on the PM Jaiswal, and two, the Subhagya scheme in Dronpara, Maudyansnam, Umya, Umpha, Domtyosau, and other areas. The two schemes referred to above is in my constituency and have not been moved forward for implementation, as the government of Assam is obstructing and creating a hurdle in the smooth implementation of the scheme mean for connectivity and electric power to our people in the rural areas contiguous with Kamrup district in Assam. Given the fact that the area where the scheme are located and to be implemented is within the boundaries of Meghalaya. This being the position, the government of Meghalaya should make its stand clear whether this area belongs to Meghalaya or Assam, as the government of Assam is obstructing the smooth implementation of this scheme and thereby denying our people the right to development in spite of the status quo on developmental works between Meghalaya and Assam. Sir, since these areas where the scheme are located is within Meghalaya, therefore I would like to urge the government of Meghalaya to give an assurance that both the Athiyabari Umchak Road under PMJSY and the Subhagya scheme in Dronpara, Maudyansnam, Umya, Umpha, Domtyosau and other area should be implemented immediately, as well as the developmental works of Meghalaya in the border area contiguous with Assam should not be stopped. Sir, I need an assurance that these schemes should not be stopped from our side and it should be implemented immediately. With these few words, sir, I reserve the seat. Thank you.
Thank you, Admiral. About Kimfa. Any other member?
Sir. Yes, Mr. George. Mr. Chairman, sir, I also rise to participate in the short duration discussion as raised by the honorable member from Nongpo pertaining to the issues of the state across the interstate border, sir. So the interstate border issue has been deliberated at length, and in this August house, you being chairman at this moment, coming from the Block 1 area, sir, and representing the people there, you know the angst, the problems, the issues that are being faced by people from time to time in the interstate border. Sir, going through the records available, especially in the Y.V. Chandrachur Committee report, the interstate border has been termed as a constitutional anomaly, and it is mere sentimental controversy. And to resolve this, only a political discussion, a political solution can bring at peace the differences that we have between the government of Meghalaya and the government of Assam. So, in our deliberations, we are pointing to two facts. One, in the 12 area of differences, where there's continually there are discussions and the meetings have been held at the Chief Minister level and the Chief Secretary level from time to time. That is one. Number two, sir, the areas where there are no differences at all, but there is a constant transgression from the Assam side to dislodge peace, harmony, development, and to bully the people living at those in those villages that are close to the Assam border. One such success is as pointed out by the honourable member from Nongpo, the transit camp in Khanapara. So, a letter from the District Council of Sketri, dated 23rd November, intimating the Deputy Commissioner of Ribhoi District that the location where the transit camp is being constructed belongs to the state through the Himamaliams. In spite of this intimation dated 23rd December 2020, a month later, when we met the Deputy Commissioner, she said she has not received this letter. So, this communication gap amongst us, forget the communication with Assam, sir. The communication gap between the District Council, the Deputy Commissioner, the District Council Affairs Department, the Chief Secretary, this entire communication gap, sir, has allowed the Assam government to continue with the construction of the transit camp there as it is. Now, after January, after our delegation of the Ribhoi District Congress Committee met and discussed with the Deputy Commissioner of Ribhoi, we expected visible action on the ground. But then, sir, till date, as we stand today, construction happens by the minute. We are not talking of area of differences. We are talking on an area that belongs to us and as claimed by the District Council. What prevents us, sir, from taking action? What prevents us? Has there been any kind of collusion between some people in our area and the officials of government of Assam? That is the allegation, sir, that there is some collusion. Some NOC must have been given sometime that allowed the Assam government to construct the transit camp there in Khanapara. So, I stand to demand that a high-level inquiry be conducted to unveil the veracity of all these allegations and also to understand the ground realities as to who are the owners of those land, which pata was issued when was the registration done under the Himamaliam, and how come did the Assam government construct the transit camp? Are there any infidels, traitors within the state, sir, who are selling our state by the day, by the minute? And these crooks should be booked if there are any, sir. Because it is because of these problems in the ground, sir, that in spite of not having any area of difference within that particular stretch that we are talking of, government of Assam still constructs a transit camp and we are not able to do anything about it. So delay in decision making will only invoke anger, and we may be seeing some more violence later. We have seen these instances, sir, where inaction will only rick up anger and people will go maybe take law in their own hands. And what will we do then, sir? So these issues pertaining to areas where there are no differences, at the chief minister's level there has been various talks where there should be ground survey, Survey of India should be involved, and boundaries should be erected in the areas where there are no differences, such as in the instant case of the Khanapara issue, sir. Therefore, sir, I join hands with the members from Nongpo and Ramrajangam to urge upon the government, sir, to take immediate steps, especially on this Khanapara issue, and stop the construction of the transit camp there in Khanapara immediately, bring a high-level inquiry, and at the same time, once the Assam elections are over, perhaps take things forward and ensure that whatever differences that lie and the constitutional anomalies that were reported or that has been submitted or the sentimental controversies be settled down through political talks and discussions at the government and the chief minister's level, sir. So with these few submissions, sir, I thank you for allotting me time. I resume my seat, sir.
Thank you, Bajaj. I would like to know if any other member would like to participate. I would like to request the minister in charge to reply, please.
Mr. Chairman, sir, at the very outset, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Sri Melbourne CM, the MLA of Nongpo, and Sri Kimpha Marbanyang, Honorable Member from Ramrai, Honorable Sri George Lingdo, Honorable Member of Umroy, for raising and participating in this short duration discussion under Rule 50 of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business, under the caption Burom Tang Ka Meghalaya Yak Ka Status Quo Habdeng Ka Assam Bat Meghalaya. Mr. Speaker, sir, seven districts of the state of Meghalaya share an interstate boundary with the state of Assam, measuring 884 kilometers in length. Since the inception of the state on 21st of January 1972, time and again we have been witnessing disputes and tensions have been escalating in the villages along the interstate border, resulting in developmental works along the interstate border progressing at a very slow pace. Mr. Speaker, sir, pertaining to the disputes that have occurred in the past few years till date, it can be stated that untoward incidents have been affecting the disputed areas, and since the year 2018 till 26th February 2021, these are the incidents which have occurred in the following areas. So I won't go district wise, I'll just give a total because it's a big chart. So the total in 2018, 28, 2019, 33, 2020, 39, and 2021, 6. Mr. Speaker, sir, the disputes along the interstate border areas have invariably led to the problem of implementing development works. And as such, many developmental works initiated by the government of Meghalaya and the government of Assam have been halted or are yet to commence because of the border differences. Mr. Speaker, sir, as on date, these are the reports of the departmental works which have been affected or completed and in progress in both the states, which are as under development works initiated by government of Meghalaya. Total completed 4, stopped 4, and in progress 2. Development works initiated by government of Assam. Total completed 4, stopped 16, which means works that were initiated by government of Assam but stopped by government of Meghalaya were 16 in number, whereas development works initiated by government of Meghalaya and stopped by Assam were 4 in number. So the works stopped by Meghalaya are much higher, sir, in number. I'll go through the details. So in Ribhoy, 14 numbers of development schemes and projects have been undertaken by both Assam and Meghalaya in the areas of differences from 2018 till 26th February 2021. Number one, erection of 7 electric posts at Yongkuli village, Meghalaya, by the Assam State Electricity Board was stopped by Meghalaya government. The Assam government tried to capture a plot of land belonging to Meghalaya at Barapathar village by erecting cement border pillars. Again, the work was stopped by Meghalaya. In the other instance, dismantling of SSA Lower Primary School at Clare Umwang village, constructed by Education Department of Meghalaya, was stopped by Government of Assam. 5 under construction BPL houses sanctioned under PMA, Pradhan Mantri Rojgar Yojana scheme, at Umro village were destroyed by Assam police. Also, construction of a road under MGNREGS sanctioned through BDO Bhoirambong was stopped by Assam. Aadhaar enrollment in Ummot village was stopped by Assam police. Construction of ICDS building under the district administration of Ribhoy was stopped by Assam police. In West Jayantia Hills, construction of Assam BOP at Khatkhasla was stopped by Meghalaya government. Construction of road at Langpi by Assam government was stopped by Meghalaya government. Construction of road from Musiam to Mokoiram, which was done by Assam government, again was stopped by Meghalaya government. Construction of road at Mokoiram by Assam government was stopped by Meghalaya government. Construction of BOP at Yorim Biam by the Assam government again was stopped by Meghalaya government. Construction of a road at Lapanga by Assam government was again stopped by Meghalaya government. The construction of road at I'll just go to the next. So in West Khasi Hills, construction of a dam site for generation of hydropower project along the Cree River was stopped by the Meghalaya due to protest by the local villagers. The construction of the road from Mokebari to Maubina was stopped by the Meghalaya government. Means Assam was trying to do it, but Meghalaya stopped it. Again, the construction of the NEC road from Hahim to Boko by the Assam government was encroaching under Saiwat village under Aradunga OP was stopped by the Meghalaya government. Encroachment at Langpi area by Assam government for construction of public fishery pond was again stopped by Meghalaya government. In Southwest Garo Hills, 2 numbers of development schemes projects had been undertaken by Assam government at Mirjumla and Sri Shima Kamakhya temple under territory of Meghalaya, and the work has been stopped by the Meghalaya government. Mr. Speaker, sir, from these figures which I have already read out in this August House, it can be seen that 4 development works initiated by Meghalaya were stopped by the Assam counterpart, while 16 development works initiated by Assam in the disputed areas were stopped by Meghalaya on the intervention of the district administration of different districts. Mr. Speaker, sir, with regards to the development works of Meghalaya, which are being obstructed too by the government of Assam, officials, the Chief Secretary, Meghalaya has written to his counterpart in Assam to intervene and issue necessary instructions not to hinder in the development works that is meant for the benefit of residents of the disputed areas along the interstate border. So the status quo is being maintained by both the states to ensure that peace and tranquility prevails in these areas of dispute. To add to some of the concerns that were raised by the honorable members, the issue of the construction of which the honorable member from Umroy was mentioning, construction of the transit camp, and there were few more other road projects that were being mentioned by member from Ramrai also. I would like to mention, sir, that on 25th of February 2021, the Deputy Commissioner has given detailed report on this issue, and she has been communicating, the Deputy Commissioner has been communicating with the Deputy Commissioner of Kamrup and taking up the matter, and has already written to the concerned Deputy Commissioner to intervene and to stop the construction of the transit camp and to be kept in abeyance. So steps are being taken, sir, and in this regards, we have always ensured that there is a process that is followed, and therefore, at most of the times, it is at the OC level or at the SP level and the DC level, these are resolved. And once it cannot be resolved with this or that level, it's scaled up to the nodal officers, and there are two nodal officers in both the states. And once it cannot be resolved at the nodal officer level, then it is escalated up to the chief secretary level. So therefore, there is a process that's followed, but I have taken due note of the points that have been mentioned by the honorable member in Umroy, and let me assure him that we will take necessary steps to discuss this with the Assam government and to figure out how we can ensure that these kind of incidents don't take place in the future also. At the same time, the honorable members had mentioned about the development schemes under the boundary, under the interstate border development program. So this program has a very small budget of about 3 to 4 crores for the entire state. And at the end of the day, these are more like untied kind of a programs and flexible programs which amount to about 30 to 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs, which are implemented in different constituencies with the border. So therefore, these are not very significant schemes as such. If you look at the entire development of the border, it's a process that takes place through all the line departments. So whether it's PHE, PWD, education, or you know, tourism, or whichever department, a large amount of investment is made through these line departments. There's a gap which may occur, and that's why the interstate boundary and border development fund was kept. But as I said, this amount is not a large amount. Therefore, it's not this money not coming in or not being sanctioned will lead to a large effect in the development process. The development takes place through the line departments, and a small amount of 30 to 40 lakhs, depending on the area, is given. But I can assure the honorable members that we have taken note of this concern. In the past also, they've mentioned it. Even the members from the ruling side have mentioned this issue. And the finance and the planning department are considering this. And we are hopeful that we'll be able to sanction some funds in the coming financial year for these interstate border development. But as I said, the amounts are very insignificant. It's not very large. Of course, every rupee matters, but the point is that when the large developments through PWD and other departments are taking, compared to those investments we make, the amount that is sanctioned under this interstate border fund is very, very negligible, sir. Sir, apart from that, the honorable members had given some concerns about some of the road projects that have been stalled by the Assam government in West Khasi's areas also. So therefore, those points also, sir, we have noted down, and we will be taking this up with the government of Assam at the chief secretary's level. And as was mentioned, sir, that last year, around the month of January, February, we had communicated to government of Assam that we need to meet to discuss the border issue at the chief minister's level. And the verbal communication I had with the honorable chief minister of Assam during that time was that we should meet sometime in the month of April 2020. But as you're aware, sir, that even after the communication was sent to Assam government, because of the COVID pandemic that hit us, those talks could not take place at that point in time. And now Assam is facing its elections. So only when the new government is installed, we will pursue this matter with the new government in the Assam, with the Assam counterparts. and we will take the discussions forward to see how we could find an amicable solution to this very, very long and pertaining problem, but a very, very important problem for our state, sir. So with these few words, I hope I have been able to clarify most of the issues that the members have raised. And with that, sir, I would like to resume my seat. Thank you, sir.
One, two clarification, sir. Can I?
Okay, just one clarification.
Sir, number one, see the allocation, as we have said, even though it is small, sir, for ISBADP, but at the border area, sir, I'll tell you, if you give construction of community hall of 7 to 8 lakhs, also it matters. With a big signboard of Dorbar Shnong Gom, it falls within Meghalaya, Hima, Malim, Raj, all this issue. So it matters, sir, if possible, to increase the budget allocation for ISBATP. Number two, sir, with regard to transit camp in Kanapara, as mentioned by the Honorable Chief Minister, thank you so much for the response, the reply, the elaborate response that you have given. We thank you for that. But construction is still going on till now also. I would like to bring into the notice of the House through you, sir, that construction is still on. Whether the report has been sent by the Deputy Commissioner, correspondent has been sent to Assam, but it is on. So I would like the government, apart from putting an inquiry to see how this thing has happened, it has to take a serious note that this construction has to be stopped once and for all.
So we'll definitely take up that matter. And regarding the developmental aspect you mentioned, so to ensure that more of these community halls can come in at the border areas, we had increased the MLA scheme also by 50 lakhs. So the Honorable MLA can also give from the MLA scheme for that 7-8 lakhs that he is mentioning. But nonetheless, sir, we will also look into this this demand, and we'll see and we'll examine on how we could provide this. But definitely, sir, I've taken note of his suggestion. Thank you, sir.
So 50 lakhs is for those who are on the border or for others also?
Sir, all, sir. All it was given, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Speaker, sir, I would like to bring to the notice of the House either the Chief Minister was misinformed or misled by someone, because the road up to Mau Sikar has been completed by the Assam through PMGSY Assam up to Mau Sikar, sir. This road is already completed, sir, in Lumpi area. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Sir, I'm sticking with the reply that has come in here, but I do have details of all the roads that are being constructed and other things. If I will just be given one more moment, there's a big chart, sir, so I have to go through this. Sir, nonetheless, as I said, I will look into the point that has been noted, given by the Honorable Member, so I'll get back to him also and to you also, sir.
Sir. So I again thank the Honorable Chief Minister, sir, for the extensive reply and his assurance to take up the matters expeditiously, sir. But then, sir, I still want to reassert one point, that the area in Kanapara, sir, belongs to us and claimed by the District Council, and letters have also been sent and a report has also been received by DC Riboy. Sir, this area is very different from the other area of defences. This area belongs to us. So I feel, sir, why do we need the permission of DC Kamrup or DC from that other side, sir, to stop this particular work, sir? I think, sir, we should assert ourselves, show authority, and then stop this work with the order from DC Riboy, sir, because the land belongs to us, sir. So this is my submission, sir. And again, would request for an assurance for the inquiry, sir, so that things can be revealed and people will know the actual problems that has led to this particular incident, sir. Thank you, sir.
So the point has been noted, sir, and definitely we'll get this matter examined in detail, sir.